Okay, so good morning guys. So for this week, we are going to tackle about the systems of linear equations in two variables for this week. Okay, so let us have a walkthrough about our lesson. So if you know how to graph the linear inequalities in a rectangular coordinate system, so it is easy for you to graph the two linear equations or the system of linear equations. Okay, so ito po yung ating learning task 1 na gagawin. So you are going to match the inequality to the graph. So here are the given inequality, then hanapin nyo. So for example, number 1, y is greater than x minus 5. So alin dito sa mga graph na ito in ABC ang graph ng linear inequality nito. Ganun din sa 2x plus y is greater than or equal to negative 2. And for number 3, we have 2x minus 3y is less than 6. So once again, meron na tayong clue kapag dash line, yan ay walang equal to dun sa ating inequality symbol. Okay? So kapag naman walang ano, merong dash, merong inequality to or equal to, so solid line yon. Okay, so madali lang siyang hanapin. Okay, so yun yung technique na ano. And then so here is the examples. So proceed tayo sa learning task 2. So for this week, meron lang tayong tatlong learning task. So for learning task 2, graph the following inequalities and identify at least 3 points that belong to the solution set of the inequalities. So yan, we have 5 items in that learning task 2. And then for our learning task 3, so you are going to answer the following. So for number 1, in a given graph, how do you identify the solution set of the systems of linear inequalities? Then number 2, when is the boundary of an inequality a broken line or a solid line? When does a system of inequalities have no solution? So pwede ba ba yun? Then for set B, write the systems of linear inequalities whose shaded region is the solution set. So we have 3 graphs here. Ano? So para masagot natin yung set B. Okay? So that's all for our week 2. Okay? Now, let us go back to our examples. So for example number 1, we have okay, so ito nga ba yung number 1 examples? Okay. So we have 3 examples here given. Ano? So for number 1, find the x and y intercepts of each inequality. So the y is less than or equal to x plus 3 and y is greater than or equal to negative 2x plus 4. So getting the x and y intercept, so if x is 0, y is equal to 3, and if y is 0, x is negative 3. So ito yung kanyang graph. Ano? Then ito yung region, solution set of y is less than or equal to x plus 3. So ito yon. And then y is greater than or equal to negative 2x plus 4. So ito naman yon. Okay? Ito yung ating graph. Then so ito yung points. So let us have the test point. Test point is 0, 0 sa graph number 1. So tama, ito nga yun, 0, 0, the origin. So ay nasa solution. Then ang kanya naman test point doon sa second graph, we have 5, 2. So 5, 2. Nasaan yung 5, 2? So ang 5 ay 2 ay ito yon, and then narito siya sa loob. Okay. So that is greater than or equal to. So above the line. Okay? Now, and then pag pinagsama natin yung dalawang graph, okay, so ito yung pinagsama natin yung dalawang graph, so itong point of intersection na ito, okay, sa baba, yun ang, itong side na to, Ito yung tinatawag nating solution set of the two inequalities. Ito na yung solution set, wherein lahat ng points na narito sa plane na ito ay true to the equation number 1 and equation number 2. Like the ordered pairs 4, 2, 5, negative 3, 6, 2, 7, negative 2, or some points that belong to the solution or solution set of the two inequalities. Okay, let us check. Sabihin, i-check natin kung siya nga ay solution set. So, once again, our first equation is, ang first equation natin ay y is less than or equal to x plus 3. And then, y is greater than or equal to negative 2x plus 4. So, ito yung ating solution. And then, we are going to test up the point or ordered pair. Ang ating itetest ay yung 4, 2. Yun ang ating test points. Let us see. So, allow me to show you my whiteboard. Okay. So, once again, substitute natin yung value ng x and y, which is 4, 2. So, we have 2 is less than or equal to 4 plus 3. And 2 is less than or equal to 7. And that is true. True yun, di ba? So, therefore, okay yan sa ating equation number 1. And then, we have 2 is greater than or equal to negative 2 times 4 plus 4. So, we have 2 is greater than or equal to negative 2 times 4 is negative 8. Added to 4. And 2 is greater than or equal to negative 4. And that is true also. Okay? So, therefore, yung 4, 2 ay solution set. Okay? So, as you can see in our graph, okay? So, ang 4, 2 ay makikita nyo dito. Diba? So, 4, 2. Yun, dito siya. Ito yung point na 4, 2. Okay? So, madali lang. Ano? How about 5, negative 3? Let us check naman yung 5, negative 3. So, kung ang point natin ay 5, negative 3, so, therefore, we have negative 3 is less than or equal to 5 plus 3. So, negative 3 is less than or equal to 8. And that is true also. True siya, di ba? Okay. And then, doon naman sa kabilang equation, we have negative 3 is greater than or equal to negative 2 times 5 plus 4. Okay? So, yan pala. 4. Okay? So, we have negative 3 is greater than or equal to negative 10 added to 4, and that is negative 6. Is it true that negative 3 is greater than or equal to negative 6? Very good. So, that is true. So, to check sa ating number line, para ma-check natin yung ating negative, di ba ito yung 0? So, negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4, negative 5, negative 6. Saan na mas malapit yung, anong number mas malapit sa 0? Diba itong negative 3. So, therefore, mas malaki yung negative 3. Okay? Para hindi kayo malito kapag meron tayong integers, which is the greater value. So, yun. Ano? So, ganun lang po kadali yung ating graphing of linear inequalities. So, let us have another example. Y is greater than x minus 1 and y is less than or equal to negative 2. So, as you can see, if x is 0, so we have 0, negative 1. Yun yung ating y-intercept. Then, the x-intercept is 1, 0. So, ito yon, di ba? Yun yung dalawa. So, connect the points. Since that is greater than lang, so dash line siya na. Dash line. And then, dito naman, there is no x-intercept. Bakit walang x-intercept? Kasi wala tayong value ng x dito. So, the y-intercept is 0, negative 2. So, ito yun. Kaya siya ay horizontal line. Kapag ang value na ang given natin ay y lang, so horizontal line yun. So, therefore, yung ito yung dito sila nag-cross. Okay? So, ito yung solution set of the two inequalities. Take note of that, ha? Ito yung solution set. Okay? Huwag malilito doon. Then, for number 3, we have x minus 2y is less than or equal to negative 4. So, the y-intercept is 0, negative 2. And we have negative 4, 0 as the x-intercept. So, ito yon, di ba? So, ito yung ating first graph. Then, the second graph, we have 6y is greater than or equal to 3x plus 2. So, kung mapansin nyo, pareho silang may equal to doon sa kanilang inequality symbol. Kaya solid yung kanyang what we call this, the line, okay? So, the points are 0 and 1 third and negative 2 third 0 yung ating x-intercept. So, ito yun. So, maliit lang, ano, kasi fraction yon. Then, nag-cross sila. Then, after sila na mag-cross, so therefore, ito yung solution set of the two inequalities. Okay? So, nag-graph din eh. Then, doon. Okay? So, on the point of intersection ay narito. So, therefore, ito po yung ating solution of the two inequalities. Okay? So, ganun lang po siya kadali. So, lahat ng napdritong points, yun yung tinatawag nating solution set. Okay? So, once again, kung may question po, so, message lang po kay sir. So, and also, we have private comments on our Google Classroom. Okay? So, once again, don't forget to subscribe our channel and click the notification bell and like our video. Okay? Happy learning!